Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to explain the steps to be followed when deploying the Bold Reports report server in Azure App Service using the ARM template. First, let me give a small introduction about the Bold Reports report server. It is an application that provides organizations with an easy and cost-effective way to add reporting capabilities to their existing infrastructure without any development effort. With this report server, you can create, manage, and share reports easily without having to write any code. One of the major benefits is that it can be deployed on premises or in the cloud, providing a deployment option that suits their needs. Let's look at the prerequisites for deploying this report server in the Azure App Service. You should have a Microsoft Azure portal subscription and a database like Microsoft SQL Server 2012 or newer, PostgreSQL, or MySQL. Make sure your database is accessible outside the machine too. Here in this table, I have provided the configuration requirements for the Azure app to be selected based on traffic and data processing. The Bold Reports report server supports basic, standard, and premium app service plans in Azure. The minimum recommended app service plan to run the application is the basic plan. Now, let me start the deployment. First, I log into the Azure portal and click Create a Resource, which will redirect to the Create a Resource page. Next, search for template deployment in the search bar. Click Create and then Template Deployment. Then choose Build Your Own Template in the editor. Here, I'm going to add the ARM template. ARM template is nothing but a JSON file that defines the infrastructure and configuration required to deploy and manage resources in Azure. I copy the ARM template from the GitHub provided in the documentation. I paste it here and save it. It will redirect to the custom deployment page. The subscription option allows you to choose Azure subscription. The resource group option allows you to choose logical group to group resources like web app, storage account, network, etc. Location option allows us to choose the location where the application is deployed. East US is preferred usually. The web app name option allows entering the report server application name according to our choice for this URL. This name should be unique. The deployment will fail if an application is already deployed in that name. I enter the value as Bold Reports Azure App. Storage account name option is used for blob storage. Like the web app name, this name should also be unique. I enter the value as Bold Reports Storage. The web app name and storage account name should be in lowercase. Storage account type is optional if you have chosen the storage type as file storage. If blob storage is the storage type chosen, then this field is mandatory. I click Review and Create. It will review the ARM template, and if are there any issues in the template, it will be displayed. Since the validation is passed, there is no error in our ARM template. I click Create. This deployment will take at least 15 minutes to deploy the application. Now, the deployment is completed, and the application is ready for startup. I click Go to Resource Group. Here, you will see the web app and storage account created. I open the web app. Next, I copy this URL from the default domain field and paste it in the browser to configure the report server. First, you need to activate the Bold Reports account either by using online credentials or by uploading the offline unlock key. You can download the unlock key from your Bold Reports accounts page and upload it here. For this demonstration, I am going to activate it by using online credentials. I click Login to activate account and enter my Bold Reports credentials. Since I have only one portal license, the portal license selection process was skipped in this setup. If you have more than one portal license, you need to choose any one. Next, I will configure the administrator user by entering the user information and password. And click the Next button. Here, configure the database to store the report server data. You can store reports in SQL Server, PostgreSQL, or MySQL databases. I choose PostgreSQL for this demo, and the fields will be reloaded based on the selected database. I provide the necessary information in the required fields. The New Database option allows you to create a new database. And the Existing Database option allows you to use an already created database in the selected server type. I choose New Database. And provide the database name, Bold Services Azure App. Then, I turn on the Enable SSL option to make a secure connection using SSL. Click the Next button. The report tenant deployment has started and will run in the background. Next, I click Go to Reports. And am redirected to the View All page. Here, the sample reports that are already available with the report server can be added by clicking Explore in the Report Sample pop-up. You will see the list of samples already available. By clicking the Add Report button, you can add these reports to the report server. They will be added under the Sample Reports category. Clicking on an added report will open it in the report server. Next, I'll open the Share Data Source Data Connector page. You will not see third-party data sources like MySQL, Oracle, or PostgreSQL here. If you want to use third-party data sources in your report, you need to install it in the report server. I'll show you how to install them. First, I stop the Azure App Service application. Then, open the Kudu PowerShell for the Azure App Service. In the created web app dashboard, click on Advanced Tools. And then go. You will be redirected to the environment page. In this page, click Debug Console. And select PowerShell. It will open the PowerShell. Next, change the current working directory to /site/www/root/client/library/bold/reports. For that, I run this command. Then run this command to install Oracle, PostgreSQL, and MySQL in the report server. Next, I start the Azure App Service web app and reload the browser. As you can see, MySQL Oracle and PostgreSQL data connectors are added. In this video, I gave a basic introduction about the report server, covered the steps to deploy it on Azure App Service, and then showed you how to add optional client libraries. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.